Centaurs. That's exactly what I saw.
Did you holler at them?
Well, we stand here in a row, looking like a bunch of heroes. I know that deep inside, nothing more but a bunch of zeros.
Welcome to Season 2, Episode 20 of Bards and Nobles, a Dungeons & Dragons podcast where we suffer warm beer while chucking dice. I am Brian the Dungeon Master, and I'm joined by...
Aaron Williams, playing Baron von Beauregard VI, the spellless ranger human.
Blake Harrison, playing Kibe Takashigani, the spellless crabman samurai.
Charles Nelson, playing Max Stormblade, the human paladin.
What's up, bros? This is Anthony Boyd playing Chris Grindel, half drow rogue. Let's crack some beers and roll some dice, yeah!
Oh, God.
Can we kill him? We're killing him, right?
Yeah, that's fine. We can kill him. I'm Moist William playing Flint Misrupted, a druid dwarf.
Y'all just stealing my shtick.
And I'm Andrew Dana, and I don't want to play anymore. I'll be playing the Warforged gunsmith Elon Musk.
Is us defining a Moist William? Is that actually like, was that recorded or no?
Everything's
it's recorded.
In
the pre-roll. I can put it in the. I mean, maybe I can just
re-roll this. Just splice this in later. This is Pam Williams playing Aaron's mom, the Crabman Samurai.
Maybe I can adjust your pitch a little bit. Sound like a lady?
Yeah.
You didn't do lady voice.
It's Pam. Pam Moist.
All right. Let's get this recap going so we can kick this off.
Let's go, Stormcock.
All right. Last time on Bards and Nobles, we woke up, went to town, and kind of like dicked around a bit. And then eventually we just set out to take all the villagers and stuff to the other town.
Blood Blossom.
That's true. Last episode was mostly just catching birds.
But we caught like 3 birds. It was pretty impressive.
We're pretty good at it. All I know is Kibe and Grits come running out of the woods, moist and whipped.
That indeed.
Happened. So yeah, that's where we're going to pick up. You guys have just set off from Harstead. With the caravan of villagers on your way to Blood Blossom Watch. You guys have been traveling at this point all day.
When we get to the area where we ran into the bandits like that first time,
because
I know some of them escaped, can I keep my eye out for some more bandits about?
Sure. Give me... Let's see. That's like actually not very far. That's not very far from Harstead itself. So go ahead and give me a... perception check at disadvantage, mostly because since you guys left, there's been a pair of villagers that have just been talking that are relatively near the front where you guys are at, and they've just been droning on and on and on about just the most unimportant things, the most mundane, boring details of their lives, and it's, you can tell it's going to be a long trip. Like, these two are just going back and forth.
It sounds like our podcast.
So meta. What'd you roll?
14.
Okay. You keep a good eye out. But you don't see anything right now.
Cool.
I'll pull this caravan over if I see any trace of bandits.
I message to the group, like, watch out for those bandits that escape.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to be towards the back of the... caravan.
Okay.
Let's watch for enemy fighters.
It's about like 60 people. I mean, you guys are spread out pretty far.
Yeah.
You're going to be at the back.
Let's say we try to get people who know how to use weapons kind of staggered throughout the formation as well.
We just pair off, 2 in the middle, 2 in the front, 2 in the rear.
Yeah, and then settlers will be responsible for some of it.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, who's in the front? Let me get this marching order down.
I'll be in the front.
All right, that's Grits. And who's with Grits? Who's pairing off with him?
No one else is going to answer, so I guess it's me.
Flint. All right. Who's hovering around the middle?
I'll be there.
And I will be with my good buddy Baron.
Baron and Kibe.
And who's...
You know what? I feel like the power's deduction.
Stormcock and Elon.
Figure out that Max... God, I actually wrote Stormcock. All right, Max and Elon.
Of course, Stormcock's in the rear.
Yeah, Grits and Flint, you guys are privy to this discussion. Right now, they've been going on and on about mushrooms, just different types of mushrooms you can find in the swamp. Another hour goes by, and you guys have made some good ground. Surprisingly, you're covering more ground than you thought you would with this many people. But they've still just been droning. These two have just been going back and forth, just talking about the most boring things.
You need to stop them.
You're not up here. You could have been up here, but you're not.
I just let them go on. I don't even care.
Another hour goes by, and another hour goes by. You guys, it's actually been pretty uneventful so far.
Apparently we killed the void, guys.
Well done.
We did it.
Thanks a lot for taunting the DM, Andrew.
You're welcome.
We at least avoided them.
The earth opens up.
Bahamut is like, nope, not that guy.
It is at this point starting to get dark, and you guys are still probably another, I want to say, 8 to 10 hours away from Blood Blossom Watch. You guys have just been marching along southeast to Blood Blossom Watch, kind of skirting the woods to your right.
Time to circle the wagons.
Immediately, one of the villagers, the speaker for the village, as it were, kind of tugs on your cloak, Grits, from behind.
Hey, whoa, hey, watch the threads, man.
He's like, oh, my bad. So what's the plan? Are we gonna park soon, or?
Oh, you guys want to park? I thought you guys wanted to get there.
Well, yeah, but now it's getting dark, and not a lot of us have been out of the swamp after dark.
All right, circle up the wagons, put everyone in the middle, and start setting up bonfires around the perimeter. And we'll camp out the next opening we see.
Okay. All right, we can do that.
Relay that to your peeps.
All right.
And I message those same instructions to like what we're doing to everybody
Sweet.
Else.
Okay. You guys, are you guys doing anything?
I suspect that Grits is baiting us into a trap, but I cautiously follow his instructions.
Yeah. I start trying to get the people in the back start moving their carts in a formation of some sort.
Okay.
I go in and start gathering up sticks.
Sticks.
Okay. You just grab you just have like a bundle of sticks with you?
I'm not going to say it.
To what?
You can't bait me into this.
I'll say it.
All right. So
say it.
At this
Trump's
point,
America.
At this point, everyone's pretty much corralled themselves and encircled around. And you guys just begin making camp. Is it?
Yep. Try to walk the perimeter, make sure like there's nothing sketchy. Like I assume we try to go into a big opening.
Yeah. Right now, you guys are definitely out of the woods and into more of the plains area.
Mm. Sweet.
Do I see any of the blood blossoms around?
No, you haven't seen any sign of them. And also the outpost itself is still pretty far away. Like you don't see it in the distance or anything.
All right, let's start.
We'll get some fires.
Just walking the perimeter, see if I can clear out spots for fires on the perimeter while having a big bonfire in the middle.
Yeah. Okay.
Can I chop down a tree?
Sure. You go
with the edge of his hand
to the nearest tree
and pinch it.
You just try to pinch it off.
Yeah.
Okay. Pinch that log off.
Give me an athletics check.
All right.
Ooh.
Does he do it?
You walk up to
23.
a relatively young tree. It's not much taller than you.
No, I find the mightiest oak.
You find a mighty oak, and you begin just chipping away at it. Not making very much progress. Your pincers aren't very built for chopping. But you're definitely scratching up against the tree, and one of the villagers who has gone out to gather sticks and firewood and fuel for the bonfires kind of sees you over there, and he's like, and you met him earlier. His name's Garrett.
Hey, Garrett.
There are a lot
Garrett
of halflings.
Or Gareth.
Sorry, I have like a list of NPCs. All right, he's a halfling. He's got blue hair, and he's just like, hey, Mr.
Takashigani.
Yeah, what are you doing there?
I'm just pinching at this tree. The mightiest one in the forest.
Oh, okay. I'm gathering sticks for the fires. You want to help?
Well, I almost have this tree down.
am I around?
Did you want to go with him?
I wanted to be around.
Yeah, you're in the vicinity also gathering gotcha. Sticks. That's the way, that was your two gotcha. Guys' duty.
Got it. I giggled to myself at hearing the word duty. And then I'd like to tell Garrett, it's like he's sharpening his claws for the incoming night terrors.
You can tell you visibly have him spooked. He's like, oh, okay, I'll bring these back to the camp then.
Yeah.
Carry on.
Make a big bonfire. You don't want to see any of those coming.
He skedaddles on good. Back to the fire. All right,
good. You owe me for that save a face.
Thanks, Barry. I don't think he's going to believe that I almost had this tree down.
What are you doing?
Just pinching the tree down.
Okay, got it.
As you guys are having this conversation, you hear a rustle in the woods. Just like that.
Got them claws sharp?
Oh, they're very sharp.
All right, we investigate.
Over to the west from the thicker part of the woods that you guys came out of, you see two figures beginning to approach.
Humanoid?
Yes, humanoid. Right now, you can only make out their shapes.
I perceive them. Can I perceive?
Sure.
Are they lovely shapes?
Is one of them a crab woman?
25.
25? Okay. Yeah, you definitely see two humanoids. Looks like two males, human, and they're just kind of raggedly making their way through the underbrush and coming through. They look unarmed. They look pretty disheveled, dirty, and you can tell they haven't spotted you yet, but they're making their way towards you.
Gotcha.
Making their way.
I point them out to Crabman. And I pull out Amelia.
And I say, ho there, travelers.
LOL.
Oh, and they definitely stop. And they're like, oh, who's out there? Oh, and then you can tell that they spotted you. At this point, everyone knows where everyone else is at. And they stop. They're like, yes, hello.
What brings you to this town? This part of the country. Town. This part of the country.
We're
just traveling
shanty town.
Town.
we just got lost. Do you have any food? Do you have anything to drink? The smaller one yells.
Yeah, gotcha. We have lots of food. Come here.
Okay. And then they begin making their way towards you.
I give them a drink from Grandpappy's canteen.
Okay. The smaller one snatches it up and he's just like, he's just
easy
chugging,
there, easy
chugging
there,
away.
Easy
oh,
there.
Oh, sorry, sorry. Wipes his mouth and hands it back.
Gotcha. I offer it to the tall one.
He takes a more controlled sip. He drinks a little bit, then hands it. He's like, thank you, stranger. Thank
Absolutely.
You.
Absolutely. lost from where heading to where?
We went hiking. We're from around here. We're from the south in the Golden Wood, and we just got lost. Me and my brother here. I'm Zook, by the way. And he goes to shake your hand.
I shake it.
All right. And this is my brother Eldon.
Zook and Eldon.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you got lost, or you live down here in the Golden Wood, huh?
Yeah. Are you from I think south of here? And he kind of looks around. He's like, it's kind of hard to tell.
Is this your first time hiking?
Yeah, we went to get some food.
Do an insight on all this.
Okay.
Do you want to do an insight with me, Kibe?
No, I just
don't metagame him.
Okay.
don't tell him.
I'm pretty dumb.
Blankly trust them.
I'm pretty dumb.
14.
No, I'm just saying Blake Harrison's pretty dumb.
What did you roll?
14.
You can tell the way he's stuttering, the way like some of the stuff he's saying is kind of sketchy. It's he is being kind of deceptive.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not being truthful with you.
Yeah, gotcha.
They definitely ain't truthing.
Do you relay this to me?
With the inside of my head, I do.
I send it over. True.
You wing 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 him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't we all hear this?
Yeah. I think it would be.
No, I mean this is a decent, decently far away from the caravan and stuff. Like you can see it in the distance, but you guys aren't close enough to share the link.
But if we send a message, everybody gets it, right? We can't.
Yeah, yeah. Us. Okay. So far, yeah.
So I walk up to the. Is one of them visibly bigger than the other?
Yes, Zook is.
I walk up to Zook.
Old Zook
and
suit,
you're
right?
Still like a foot taller than him.
And I grab him.
Okay. Just by his shoulders or like you bear hug or
by
what are you doing?
By his wiener.
I mean, I guess just by the shoulders, but I got a good grip.
He flinches at the touch and you can tell he's kind of trembling under yours.
And I say, Zook, we're looking for two bandits that escaped justice.
The honesty is too
immediately,
much.
Zook kind of shoots a look over to Eldon. And he's like, I didn't know these woods had bandits in them. I'm glad we haven't run across them yet. You can tell he's lying.
Sweet.
Shake him like a baby.
So I'm like, well, why don't you just come with us to the caravan?
He's like, we got the water. Really, we were just getting parched. We've been lost out here for a while. But we don't want to trouble you guys anymore. And he starts beginning to
It's no trouble. Night's already fallen. Risking your lives if you leave now.
Yeah, and I say I believe we spoke of getting you guys some food.
Well, I mean, no, I don't think we're not very hungry. And you can tell Eldon's just looking. His eyes are darting back between you two.
I insist.
I just kind of forcibly start pushing Zook towards the caravan.
What's your AC?
16.
Zook tries to step on your foot forcibly, like as a strike. But he misses because your crab anatomy is foreign to him.
I said, you almost just stomped my penis.
And he's like, Zook, run. Or he says, Eldon, run. And Eldon begins dashing off, and then he tries to run off. Give me an athletics check.
Crush him.
Dang it. 12.
The surprise from when he tried to stomp on your foot, he with his momentum, he kind of twists out of your grasp, and they immediately run off in the other opposite direction.
And I say, Baron, shoot them. Tripping shot.
Let's let them go and report it to the others, and we'll just keep an eye out. I don't know if it's worth all that.
I just put my head down and I'm like, you disappointed me. It's our second chance to kill the bandits.
At this point, yeah, they're gone into the woods.
Gotcha. I'll tell the others. I'll put everyone on notice. So all I right. go around and I tell Grits and Shrimp and Elon and Max about what just happened and tell them to be cautious of bandits through the night.
Did you recognize them?
Did I recognize them?
You did not.
I did not. Well.
The intelligence check.
Roll for remembering.
Natural 20.
Natural 20? You didn't see their faces because they had masks on at the time.
Yeah.
But you do recognize their builds.
Mm.
And you're putting two to two together. You are almost 100% certain there are two of the bandits from the chasm when you guys first went up there.
Mm.
And they ran off.
Gotcha.
Oh, the two from the bridge?
Yeah.
I can't be sure of their faces, but I feel certain it's them.
Why just from the shoot
whom?
The two bandits that... that escaped when we were
you weren't there
when
you
we were bringing them. Grits knows
baby stuff. No, I was there when they escaped.
No, you weren't. No,
oh, those? This is, oh,
this
different
is,
ones?
This is a different one.
Different one.
Yeah. Oh, okay. All right.
No, we they weren't aided and abetted by you.
Let's not talk. Let's not talk about that whole event.
That we episode all never happened. I would like to anchor another smaller, almost as mighty tree, but much less
going,
mighty.
I'm just going back out into the woods.
Yeah, I'm just going out back in the woods.
All right, you find a less mighty tree.
I don't leave him alone.
And I attack it.
I don't want him to go out there by himself.
All right, all right.
Guarding, keeping an eye out, making sure he doesn't get ambushed.
Again, Grits and Kibe go out into the darkness away from the group.
I think there's something going on there.
All right, you get exactly players chips roll from Boyd, like splitting the party repeatedly?
I didn't do this.
All right. I can immediately punch you.
He blamed me for Crabman killing his bird earlier.
What did you roll?
I rolled a 10, but like I have to add stuff to it, don't I?
Yeah. I mean, you're trying to pinch a tree off. It's
no,
pretty hard.
My anchor his anchor.
Oh, you're hitting with your anchor. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
So 16.
How much damage? Because you hit. It lands pretty solidly against the trunk. And having chosen your target wisely, it's a little smaller, so there's a bigger chance that you'll be able to fell this mighty oak.
I can't re-roll those.
But not as mighty as the first one.
Add your strength to it.
Seven damage?
Seven. I thought your attack rolls.
And it's a blunt weapon. You, it reverberates back in your hand a little bit. You're able to put a nice dent in it, but you don't like chip anything off or, you know.
I like a crab man. I think we got enough firewood. You don't really have to chop this tree down. We should really make our way back to the camp and make sure the setup.
Where do we get all this
watches
firewood from? I've been out here gathering all night and haven't gotten any.
Well, if you've been gathering like this, I can understand why. I was like, come on, man.
Am I
let's
over
just
there with them?
Did you go over there with them? Did you want to? You saw Grit sneaking off with Kibe.
I wasn't sneaking off.
Yeah, I followed.
Putting.
I'd also like to point out
I assume everything you do is sneaky.
Whoa.
No, I'm a rogue.
I'd also like to point out. Not because he's a drone.
I guess I'm headed back to tell.
Way to stereotype.
I'd like to point out to Kibe, it would take months for that to dry out to where we could burn it, just so you know.
I hit it again.
All right, I head back to the camp.
12.
Yeah, you hit it, but it doesn't do very much damage.
You haven't rolled damage.
I know.
He's just letting you know.
All right, so
it's a forewarning.
At this point, Greens, you're just watching him just whack this tree.
Kibe, come on, man. Let's head back.
I Grits. Okay, I don't remember. All right, fine.
I cast Puppet.
Why can you do that?
Yeah, it's one of my new spells I picked up.
Nice.
So you guys head back. Everyone's back at the camp.
I'm like, who wants to take up watch? I do think we need to, because both of you guys have firearms. Do you have sights on your firearms, both of you? Are we all together?
Yeah, everyone's back at the camp.
Okay,
we're
good.
All together.
It's dark. It's nighttime at this point. Fires are roaring.
Yeah. I'll take first watch.
I'll be good. I have a lantern.
You've for this many people, there's one major bonfire, and then you've set up a couple on the perimeters, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
I think we should have like three villagers at each fire on the outside, and then one of us within 2 points on it, and then we can each rotate watches like that.
Mm.
That way we have all spaces covered, make sure everyone's on alert for those bandits and stuff and for any of the monsters.
Yep.
Who wants to take first watch?
I'll take first watch. Elon, do you want to take it?
Yeah,
together.
I'll take it.
Okay.
Well, there's only six of us, so there can't be two of us on each of the watches.
I mean, even when I go and do my little short rest or whatever, because I don't need a long rest, I'm still alert to everything. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I can just get in a position where I can see stuff. And
I want to scurry up a tree.
All right, you scurry.
Sweet.
Then I go and take a nap, or take a sleep.
I sleep.
I'll take second watch.
I'll take second watch with Max.
Gotcha. I will take third watch.
I will also take third watch.
Wait, sure you will.
Oh, my God.
What? Wait, there's four. Why are there four watches? Why can't we just have three watches?
8 hours?
There's three.
Anyways.
You have 8 hours to do with what you will. So
yeah,
just
we
let
got
me
three
know
watches. Whatever.
Let's just
we
do
3/8 of a watch.
Yeah. Oh, so we're not taking like a rest. We're just watching for 8 hours.
Yeah.
We're resting. Doing a short rest or whatever.
Yeah. Short rest. Anyways.
We haven't done anything to deserve a long rest.
I'm up in a tree.
Yeah, I thought we were waiting the night out or something.
Keeping an eye out over the party in case I see any non-do-gooders.
All right.
Do-batters.
All right. I'm walking around the camp.
I take a long rest until someone wakes me up.
All right. So you're walking around. Baron, you're up in the tree.
Yes.
You can see most of the villagers, you know, getting into their sleeping bags or lean-tos or little... You know, camping.
I've got my lantern
equipment
shuttered for the moment, but if I need it at a moment's notice, I will unshutter it.
Okay. Give me a perception check.
I perceive. Let me do this. 12.
Let's see. About 20 meters west of the encampment, you see two figures who have... tried horribly to hide and disguise themselves in some sticks, but they're quite obvious. It's almost comical how badly they're sticking out.
Gotcha.
They're sticking out.
And you can see them. They're both. It's obviously the two people you ran into earlier, and it looks like they are also staking out the encampment.
Gotcha. I'm going to take my steel mirror and I'm going to reflect the light of my lantern into the eyes of Elon. To get his attention.
Okay.
Elon, you are temporarily blinded for a second.
You have a message. You could just message him. And then
you see him up in the tree.
I just kind of wave at him what is he doing?
And I point and I tell him that where I'm pointing, those are the bandits.
Okay. I pull out TMC and I start looking for where he pointed at.
I want to message him and ask him, how do you want to handle this? Apprehension or deliverance? Are we delivering death?
I mean, it would be
you look down.
Like the movie like Deliverance?
You have a scope, right?
Yeah.
Or is there a scope?
I mean...
Anyways, you see the two down there, and you can see them as well. They're actually not even paying attention to the camion anymore. It looks like in the middle of bickering with each other. They have horrible stealth rolls, for the record. It was like a 1 and then a 3.
How do you want to handle this? Do you want to apprehend them? Or do you want to...
It's almost like Three Stooges, they're nudging each other and arguing back and forth.
Why yada.
I don't really want to. The last time we apprehended anybody with this group of people didn't end well.
That's how I feel.
I mean, I say we just kill them.
Kill them all and let Paylor sort them out, I say.
Well, I feel pretty confident that it's them, but we can...
I can go and apprehend them if we want to do that. If you'd rather do it that way.
I don't know. We can just keep an eye on
them. Does this message wake us up?
Yeah, anyone who's around, you guys can hear it. No. No, it does not disturb you if you're sleeping.
Sleep.
Okay. Well...
But everyone else can hear it.
Okay. Well, I guess I'll go wake up the other guys.
Does anybody else have any input?
I am asleep. But you also know deep down that my vote is killed them.
Yes.
Max?
Well, I'm asleep.
Okay, well then never mind.
Okay. So, I mean, you can provide... Flint? If you want to provide...
I'm asleep.
Okay,
If you want to provide cover, I can just go get them. And if they do anything weird, just shoot them.
Just send Nibbles after them?
I could do that.
Yeah. I feel like there's no need for bloodshed. We can apprehend them or spook them off. I mean, they haven't done anything to us yet.
That's true. But Nibbles, go say hi.
In the canyon.
But listen, I can't identify their faces. I feel strongly about it. I feel strongly that it is them, but I haven't identified their faces, so I'm not going to act on that.
All right. Well, I tell Nibbles to go fetch.
Okay. Immediately, Nibbles perks up, turns, looks at them, his eyes zoom in, and he takes off running, crashing through the woods, and you see both of them jump up and begin running in the opposite direction. And they both, all three, the two bandits and then Nibbles, they run off into the darkness. A few minutes later, you hear the familiar sounds of the clomping of Nibbles' steps as he makes his way through the brush and is dragging by his mouth hanging by the nape of his collar, you see the smaller one, Eldon. And he just slams him in front
of you. Gotcha, bitch.
Good boy.
All right.
And he's like, and so please, please, no, don't. Time up.
I hop down out of the tree.
All right.
And go up to him. It's just like, what are you doing, man? We gave you a chance to run off. What do you do? Why are you coming back?
It's like, I just wanted to get some food.
Mm. Well, look where that got you.
Has all this woken everybody up?
Sure. Yeah. Nibbles was not quiet. He was crashing through the woods. So,
I mean,
yeah.
It's a 550-pound
exactly.
Robo-rat.
I wake up, heading over, and be like, what the fuck is going on, guys?
We found this one sneaking around the encampment.
Cool.
There were two of them, but the other one got away.
Oh, is this one of the guys you were talking about earlier?
Yeah. I can't identify the faces, but I feel like it's one
can
of the
bandits. Can I pull his mask off and see if I remember his face?
He's not wearing
he doesn't
a
have
mask.
A mask. Not that's the time? Reason he can't recognize him, because earlier they had a mask.
Yeah.
Can you go now back to time and pull off that guy's mask?
Time travel.
Oh, well, I was like, I mean, if you guys want to interrogate him, continue on.
I don't know if I care to. I mean,
you want me to?
I'm just trying to keep the villagers safe. That's all I'm really caring about at this point.
Let me have a talk with him. I want to talk with him. I've been
he's
down,
tied up, yeah.
And I look him in the eyes like, hey, buddy, how are you doing?
He doesn't verbally respond. He's just like shaking now. He's looking around, eyes darting back and forth between everyone who's standing there.
I'm like, yeah, look around. You catch yourself in a really tight spot. Now, why was he just spying on the camp? I look back at like Elon and
he claims that he was trying for some food.
Okay, he just wanted some food. I can respect that. I've been hungry before. I break off like some of my rations and like I feed it to him like just a little bit.
He's kind
of
apprehensive about it, but he takes a bite and he's chewing excitedly.
And it's like now it's like we're just trying to safely get these people to Cedlio and stuff. Did you have any ill intentions for this group of people?
It's like no, I didn't. We weren't going to hurt anybody. I swear.
Okay, insight check him.
Yeah,
he says that. Sure.
I want to as well.
Also, right. Question: does he recognize the cape that I'm wearing? Because I'm wearing
you
the
can't,
leader's cape.
You can't tell at this right now. He hasn't shown any sign of it.
Natural one.
All right, you believe him?
I got a 5.
Yeah, I mean, he seems pretty genuine.
I'm like, all right. Is it just you two out there?
Yeah.
All right. Now here's the $1 million question. Were you with the bandits that we cleared out earlier? And be honest with me, because lying to me ends very, very poorly. Because these two guys, very good guys. Me, very not a good guy.
Give me an intimidation check.
Not too good at common either.
Natural 20.
Natural 20. He, you can tell he kind of has a lump in his throat. And he's like, he nods and looks down. He's like, yeah.
All right.
I thought as much.
But it wasn't my fault. Camus made us do all that.
Okay. All right. So if we just drag you with us as Cedlio and just turn you over to the authorities, are you going to be okay with that and not cause us any trouble?
Yeah.
It'll be a safe journey. You'll get fed. You'll get water. Then you'll have a proper trial.
That's... He's like, that's all we wanted to do. We just wanted to get out of here. We were hoping to grab one of those. And he points over at one of the mounts that are just chilling out.
All right. I'm going to walk you out to the woods. You're going to yell for your buddy. And if you guys cooperate and come down, we are not going to hurt you. We will feed you. We'll give you some water. And you'll be fine.
And you'll get a very nice report to the king about your behavior. About your cooperation.
Get all stars on your report card. he nods. He's like, okay. I don't know if Zook will go for it, but okay.
Well, that's fine. If not, then he gets to stay in this godforsaken place. And all right. I walk him over to the edge, not too close to the woods, you know, about 50 feet from the woods.
Okay.
From the edge of the woods, and just let him yell out for Zook.
All right. He starts yelling out for him. He's like, Zook! Zook!
I follow Grits.
Come on, man. Come on. Nothing.
Like, well, it looks like your buddy wants to sit here and rot in the woods. So, walk him back, and I asked Baron, it's like, hey, Baron, you want to help me pat him down for any
knives? I gave him an ocular pat down, but I'll follow it up. And I frisk down. Him.
All
right. I also frisk him.
Yeah, you're going to invest. You know what? He doesn't have anything on him. He's just got rags at this point.
I take those.
He is naked.
just kidding. Just kidding.
He is completely naked.
No. I put the rags back.
All right.
I sit him down next to me, and I have basically a trail rope from his whole thing of ropes to my waist. And I was like, all right, you're just going to sit with me. You're going to be tied up. And I just feed him like rations and just kind of talk to him and stuff like that.
Okay.
And be not as murdery as I've been in the past.
Okay.
I feel like karma has really screwed me lately.
All right.
And just keep that until my watch.
Gotcha. As you've now attained a new prisoner, as the night goes on, the rest of the villagers in the caravan, you know, everyone's pretty much staying asleep. Even the ones that have been posted up, you can tell they're not used to this kind of thing. So some of them have fallen asleep at their watch. But the rest of the night goes on pretty uneventful. And the morning comes.
Sweet.
Everybody packs up and is ready to head off. You guys do anything?
Do we have him bound?
Yeah, he's bound.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha. All right.
I say we affix him to kind of one of the mounts. Like,
I don't think he's gonna. I don't think he can best the rhino.
Well, he's
a Nibbles may be a little bit more vigilant.
He's affixed to me right now.
Oh, is he? Okay.
Yeah, I mean, we can put him. We can tie him to Nibbles, or just have Nibbles carry him.
We could have Nibbles carry him. We can just tie him to Nibbles. It's fine.
We can just throw him in one of the carts and have one of the villagers like watch him. It's like if he moves, stab him.
Yeah, but then he's got like the Nibbles easy way out.
I feel like Nibbles is a little bit more vigilant.
Oh, that's fine.
Yeah. We'll just tie him up to Nibbles and I'll tell Nibbles to watch him.
All right. Tie him to Nibbles.
Okay.
With my best knot.
Time to Nibbles and you guys head off on your way.
Yep.
A few hours go by and up ahead in the distance you can see Blood Blossom Watch.
Sweet.
All right.
You roll up to Blood Blossom Watch. Gates open.
I
see you're met with a couple familiar faces, along with questioning faces. You know, this massive group of people, and you see
my captain
is Thorzug there.
The leader, Thorzug. He walks up, and whoever's in front, he embraces. Just like, hey guys,
who got the hug?
I make sure to get the hug.
Jumps in and then hugs him.
What's up, Thorzug? How you doing, man?
He's like, welcome back. And I see you've brought some friends.
Yeah, these are all the settlers from Harstead. And,
well, most of them, anyway.
We are transporting the Cedlio because they didn't want to live in the swamp anymore.
Okay, okay.
We also have a bandit. You have a jail cell or anything you can throw him in for the night?
I guess so. Yeah, we can rig something up.
All right.
Awesome.
That's him attached to the giant Roboraptor.
All right. He whistles and kind of nods to him, and two people rip him down and bring him as he looks at you forlorn. Elzod does.
Do they have a post office?
Or Eldon.
I just look at him like, behave.
All right. Yes, they do.
Cool.
Well, it's not a post office, but they have like a mail system that messengers and stuff like
that. Can I pull Thorzug to the side? Like after we get everyone like settled and like, hey, these are our people. Like, can we set them up in an open space or whatever?
Sure. Yeah.
And just for the night.
He's like, yeah, wherever people can find a room, you know, we serve the kingdom. So if any of its people need help, you know, that's what we're here for.
And then I pull him to the side and ask, hey, how'd that hunt for the horses go?
He's like, actually, I'm glad you guys came by. I wanted to talk to all of you about that.
I messaged the group and tell us we need to meet up.
Okay, and, I'm at their post office.
I meet up.
Writing a letter to Norik that we've arrived at Blood Blossom Watch with the villagers in tow.
Okay.
And, you know, just letting them know that we're headed to Cedlio with them. And then one to my family.
Okay.
Telling them of my adventures and everything. And then, you know, one letter to my son.
So one to your family and one to your son?
Yeah. So like one to my, you know.
So three letters total.
Three letters total. One okay. addressed specifically to my son.
Okay, cool.
What's the average cost of postage?
can we get forever stamps?
They say for you guys.
I flex my Dawnguard jewel.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. You don't have to pay for that.
Yeah, flex my jewels at them.
Flex your jewels on them.
Pull out your goat
we
sack.
Get, if we get shirts, that's going to be the first shirt. Flex your jewel.
Flex your jewel.
Flex your jewel on them.
And then I meet up.
Okay, so you guys, you cross the bridge to the almost like the command hut. Because this is the way it's laid out. So you guys are over here in this. Okay, this one nice. Over here. And Thor's is like close the door. Says to you, Max.
All right, I close the door.
He's like, all right. So I follow those tracks. And they lead south. They lead into the Goldenwood. And you won't believe what I saw.
What'd you see, bro?
Check this. Half horse, half men.
I don't believe you.
I told you.
Wait, time out. Didn't you say something about your book about centaurs?
Centaurs. That's exactly what I saw.
Did you holler at him?
Deep cut inside joke. Guys, you know what? I'm going to put the explanation to that joke in the details of the show.
He's like, no. I saw them carrying crates. All right? Crates filled with gold. And jewels and weapons.
Ooh.
What type of weapons?
The kind of everything that could fit in crates.
The kind of fit in crates.
I mean, like, did you see them, like, do they have, like, a city there or an encampment?
That's the thing. They brought it to, I'd never seen it in a map before, but they brought it to a lake. All right? They dropped it off on the edge of a lake. Okay? And then they left. They just left it there.
Huh.
Now, me, I've been around for a while. I wasn't dumb enough to go check it out, so I waited. And I waited, and I waited. Until I saw something come out of the lake. Grab all the crates and bring it back down.
How long did you wait?
I waited till nightfall, at least. It was like a few hours.
Hmm. Huh. What grabbed it? It had to be something huge.
That's it. It was a dragon.
Was it a purple dragon?
What? No. It wasn't a purple dragon.
What color dragon was it?
And he looks at you and there's like a glimmer in his eyes. He's like a gold dragon.
Hmm.
Oh, shit.
Interesting.
I pull out my map and I ask Thorzug if he could mark it on my map.
Okay. And yeah, he's like, yeah, right here. And he goes and circles it on the map.
Can I tell Thorzug a little bit? I was like, we encountered a dragon underneath a lake as well in the north in the bog. It was a like a dragon made out of amethyst. But he seemed to be like growing into the wall. But for something for a dragon just to be there, like if they're worshiping it or something, that's a whole nother thing.
It's like no. He was big and I don't know. They just left it there. I'm assuming for it, and he took it. He took it all.
Now this seems to be pretty far south. How long did it take you to get down that far?
Well, riding by myself, it took the better part of a day.
Hmm.
Yeah, maybe something to check out once we get all these.
So you spent the night in the woods?
Yeah.
How?
I mean, I found a nice deep hole and I laid in there. I've been surviving in this world for a while. I've got my tricks.
Fair enough. I just want to know how to survive without building a giant bonfire.
there's ways.
Well, I appreciate you telling me this. Do you have a recollection? I want to pull out a parchment and I want to sketch his description of a centaur.
Okay.
To add to the bestiary.
Gotcha. Yeah, he goes over, you know, the four legs of it's the exact, you know, depiction he's seen in books of horses and stuff, mm-hmm. but like with a man's upper body, just like a traditional centaur.
Mm, gotcha. I draw all that. All
right. He's like, I'm thinking of taking some of the troops here and going back down there and seeing if we can find anything. You interested?
Highly.
Incredibly.
We got to return these people to Cedlio, but we definitely want to check this
out. It'd probably be a week before we could be involved.
A week? It's only a day and a half ride to Cedlio.
I don't know if I can wait a week.
Whatever is in there that we have to deal with, and then a week back.
4 days would be the soonest we could get back.
Yeah.
It's like, I'll try to wait, but I've already told a couple of guys, and we're really looking forward to it.
We could tell the villagers that they need to wait here because of something dangerous, and then we go do this thing for a little while.
Loyalty should be to the mission first.
Or we just run.
The mission is to keep the people safe. What safer place could there be?
But we can't have these people draining the supplies of this place and this place.
I ask Captain Guy, like, is it cool if we leave these villagers here for a few days while I go do this thing?
I don't know. We're already down on actual soldiers, you know, with the ones that we'll be taking. And that's a lot of people. We don't have that many rations on hand at any given time.
Socialism is just not going to support this many immigrants. Yeah.
So what we could do...
That's true.
So what we could do is run these villagers to Cedlio, and then we meet them at a rendezvous outside of the forested area. So they leave from Blood Blossom, we leave from Cedlio, and we just meet there. Because it's about a day's hard ride from both Cedlio and Blood Blossom, isn't it?
Yeah, I think you can make it from Cedlio.
So, I mean, we could probably... That way, we're not draining Blood Blossom's resources, and then we can go check this out, and we don't have to wait 4 days.
What do we do if the king gives us another assignment?
I mean...
We tell him that we need to go and do this.
I'm just saying, we don't have to report in right when we get there. We drop them off and then leave again.
We take the assignment. Maybe that assignment takes an extra 2 days because, you know, dragons and shit.
I think we can convince the king that this is worth checking out.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, sure.
We could.
He's like, well, exactly. I mean, does the king have to know? I don't want to make a big hullabaloo about it, but.
Yeah, no hullabaloos.
Come on, guys. A gold dragon.
We take these people to Cedlio. We meet them at Centaur Lake.
Centaur Lake.
And then we, you know, we do some business.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If the king gives us another assignment.
See, if we don't.
It takes us an extra couple of days to do whatever he assigned us to do.
I mean, we're the Dawnguard. We are servants of the king first and private citizens second. We don't. We're.
I don't know if I signed up for that.
We're bound to the king.
Uh-huh.
We're an extension of his will. We don't get to make our own choices. We have to follow his will. That's what being a Dawnguard is.
I don't remember reading that.
I think it's in the terms of agreement. I think we do have to tell the king.
Yeah.
Because there's now two dragons.
Yeah.
That we found underneath lakes.
And I think
this
is worthwhile for the king to know.
Well, I mean, what we could.
But I think we tell this only to the king.
Yeah, well, what we can agree. What we could do, drop off the settlers and then just mention to the king that we have heard rumors of a dragon sighting and we were gonna go check it out.
We can just tell
We
can just tell them that we got another lead on a similar situation in the south and we need to investigate.
I think the king deserves to know this information and I think he'll warrant a search on it.
Yep.
Yeah, I think with Thorzog, I look at Thorzog, I'm like, we can definitely make it to where it's not a big deal. But this does need to be investigated, and it does seem like so far it's a bigger part of the mission that we're on for the king as well. So I know you don't want him involved, but he's going to have to be involved.
We won't tell all the details about the gold and the weapons and
You have to understand, Thorzug, like, we're the servants of the king. We can't just withhold information from
him. Yeah, no, I know. I'm not trying to hide anything. I'm just... And you can tell, like, he's getting, like, twitchy. Like, he's super excited. He's like, I just got to check it out.
Don't worry, man. I want to check it out, too.
I was like, just hold off a little bit longer. Let us come with you. And that way, if we do find something, something does go down, you and your whole group, man, it's going to be getting paid. It's going to be great for you guys.
So, I mean, just meet us, and we kind of like look at the map, just meet us, you know, at this location outside of the lake in 3 days.
We'll, 3 days.
3 days. Give us enough time to get there, report to the king, and then head out.
It'll be a hard sell, but I'm pretty sure I can get them to hold off for 3 days.
By the way, have you seen a fancy-looking dude on a hover bike named Barnabas?
Yeah, Barnabas Eustace Prescott. He came through yesterday.
What did he say?
Yeah.
He said he was on a special assignment from the crown. He said it was above my pay grade to tell me what was going on.
He's polishing some
First
knobs.
Off, fuck that guy.
Don't. It's not worth it.
He chuckles at both of those.
Second off, yeah, that dude has been a headache for us. If you see him again, make sure to give him, you know,
herpes.
I mean, if you can, yes, but just be a pain in his ass if you see him again.
If there's anything you can do,
if
to
you can
slow
combine
him down,
those into one action,
if there's anything you can do to slow him down, we'd appreciate it.
He's like, all right, I got you.
Yeah. It doesn't have to do anything to do with his ass if you don't want
herpes
it to.
Or pain.
Yeah.
He's like, okay, all right. So
keeps on giving.
All right, let's get some rest.
3 days.
3 days. Let's get some rest, and then we'll ride out in the morning. We'll take all these people over.
Yep.
I like it.
As he exits the hut, or his little command center. He kind of nods at a couple of the other members, and you guys disperse. And you can tell he's excitedly telling specific people about
Where's his woman at?
She's off helping villagers like set up and settle in and things like that.
I would like to find her.
What?
I would like to find her.
You found her. She wasn't hiding. So she's
just whenever you get done doing serious stuff, let me know, because there's some unserious stuff I would like to do.
What was that? Like, Gonzal? Was that her name?
Yeah.
I would like Gonzal to do serious stuff until morning when we leave.
You will take that point of exhaustion. Go ahead.
And is anyone else doing anything?
I yield my time to Boyd.
Oh my god. you find her.
I go off. I pull her to the side or whatever, and I ask her like,
she resists.
Fair enough.
He pulls her arm free. He's like, what's up?
I was like, how's things been going here?
Things have been going good. Things have been going good. Thorzug seems pretty excited. What did he tell you?
Oh, has he not told you about what he's going to do?
Oh, he told me, but what did he tell you?
About the centaurs?
What'd you say?
You know, centaurs. You know. What's up?
She's like, yeah, we talked about it.
All right, but you know about that other thing?
What other thing?
You know what thing.
All right, Grits, I don't have to worry about this.
All right. I was like, I'm just messing with you. I'm just making sure that if we're going on the mission, I was seeing if you were going to be there, what higher officers are going to be here.
Gotcha. Night falls. Everybody rests. There's couple people hanging out. It's not quite the celebration that you guys were privy to last
time.
Same
monster attack?
No, with all the lights on the perimeter walls have been lit up. It's pretty clear.
Alright.
All the huge floodlights come on when the sun starts to go down.
Nice.
Perimeter is well protected. The gate is drawn. Everyone's pretty safe inside.
Sweet. Right.
Morning.
Another night passes. You guys saddle up.
We ride.
Thorzug gives you a knowing look and nod.
I give
and
him
he
that
holds
same
up his fingers.
Look.
He's like, 3 days. He mouths it. He says, 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you guys head off to Cedlio.
Hooray!
Cedlio!
We ride hard. Trying to push him.
Okay. Like, all right. You can tell some of the villagers are kind of struggling to keep up, but they're pretty much at your whim at this point. It's like driving cattle.
Yeah.
Yeah. The ones that are slowing down, maybe we can like pick them up on the mounts and put them on carts and stuff.
Or put them down. You decide.
I keep my eye out for centaurs. And also centaur tracks.
Gotcha.
How would you know if it's centaur tracks or horse tracks?
That's I was like, AKA horse tracks.
All right.
You actually make very good time. You see the shining city of Cedlio crest the horizon. And within a few hours, you are at the giant main gates.
Hooray! Walk to the main gates, flex my jewel, and be like, all right, let's let us in. We got some settlers from Harstead coming.
Catan.
Yeah, the gates weren't closed or anything. They immediately, like, you know, some of the people recognize you, and they bow and let you in. And they
still flex my jewel on them.
One of the main guards, he asks, what is this, pointing to the villagers?
Some villagers from Harstead, tired of living in a shitty ass bog, have come to live in the big city and become great providing citizens.
We bring with us refugees.
Yeah, apparently the corporation that was running that settlement abandoned them. So
he says, what corporation
was it? Field and Stream or whatever it was. I don't know.
I roll for remembering.
Fielding Company, right?
No.
No.
I roll for remembering.
Fielding.
All right.
History check.
Farfig Nugan.
What do you want? History?
Yeah.
Oh, we really need to take notes.
11.
It's Fortune Fields.
Fortune Fields.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Fortune Fields.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Oh, interesting. All right. So he calls a couple guards over. Immediately, people start tending to them, bringing them into the city. They're very accepting and open arms of these Fugees that have come in.
All right. I was like, all right, guys, let's head straight to the captain.
The captain or the king?
Yeah, straight to the king.
To the king.
Sure.
To the king.
I'm sure we'll be stopped to before we get king. To him.
We head
but
to the king.
Let's go there.
As you say that, you're stopped before you get to him. one of the guards you met last time you were in the city... Cage. He was stationed outside of the
First
war
name
hall.
Luke?
Hmm? No, no.
I was going to say Nicholas.
I think it's Johnny.
Oh my God. He says, Dawnguard. The Rune Lord Norik requests your presence at the war hall immediately.
Cool. Let's ride.
Let's immediately go there.
All right, now.
We do that.
All right, you make your way through the city, navigating. It's not quite winding. It's
roll
it's
for
actually
cramming
pretty,
into the episode.
Pretty big metropolis.
What? Roll for cramming into the episode.
Thanks for my urchin feature. We can go through cities at normal speed. Awesome.
Yes.
Let's say that your party could travel through a city twice as fast when not in combat.
You make it to the war hall.
Hooray! But like twice as fast. Even though we're talking about how fast it was and it's taking more time now that we're talking about it. We traveled there really, really fast.
Shut up. I just want to use that feature.
I just want to point out how fast it was.
Twice as fast.
As you approach the war hall, main doors immediately open up.
Man.
And Rune Lord Norik and his statuesque build. He comes striding out towards you.
I stride up to him.
I also stride up to him. One would say with a pimp limp.
He says, come inside. We need to talk.
You don't mind me dinner first?
He leads and walks back inside. He strides back inside.
I follow him.
I stride behind him, but my legs are little, so it takes longer.
As you're
twice
navigating,
as fast.
As you're navigating the hallways, he's kind of just informing you. He says, so hopefully you have some good news for us. We've actually found out a little bit about, he kind of does this like look around. He says about the council.
What'd you find out?
Did a bird tell you?
I mean, I did get your message. So that's how I knew, you know, you guys were coming.
All right.
But no, we found out, we were able to capture a spy or one of their informants. So after navigating through a couple hallways, he nods at some of the guards that were accompanying you guys.
I was like, please let me interrogate him.
They kind of stand back and he's like, this is the room. And he lifts up a giant bar on the door. And he opens the stone and metal latticework door, creeps open, and you see suspended there, facing away from you. It's a small, maybe like 10 by 15 room, nondescript. There's a couple of orbs on the wall. Looks like magic wards and things like that. Seems to be a female elf who's kind of just arms are chained up. And on, let's see, she's got blonde hair.
I immediately stop.
Ponytail. And two of you immediately recognize the red tattoo going down her arm on the right side.
And I pat Grits, or I pat Shrimp. I'm like, and I point to the tattoo.
Do I notice that?
Are you being sneaky about it? Are you trying to be sneaky about it?
Yeah, I'm trying to be sneaky.
All right, give
about
me a stealth. Stealth check.
Sleight of hand.
Against my passive.
Oh, you can do sleight of hand.
Against my passive perception.
Okay. Yeah. Sorry, I don't know. I'm trying to give you other options.
Uh-oh.
18?
My passive perception is 18. Who wins that?
Yeah. I think if it meets... You notice him immediately stop and kind of just like nudge Shrimp. You don't see him point or anything. You don't see what it's about. You don't see his face, but you just notice that he nudged him for some reason.
Hmm. Maybe he was just pointing out that awesome tattoo.
And so at this point, Norik's like, so we've been able to get some information out of her. And I think we found out our next move. What information did you guys have?
Baron, you want to tell him?
Yeah, so she was a spy amongst the king, or you? What organization was she spying in?
No, we got a lead, and we're pretty sure that she's with the council. She's at least, we're almost 100% sure she's with the council. Based on some of her leads, we've been able to find more council hideouts in the city. And so he leads you over to the front of her. And you two immediately recognize her as Kariah, the chick that you first met in the city that gave you the
messenger.
Yeah.
She's the one who gave us our bars, right? That got us in.
Yeah.
Shit.
And she, one busted eye, blood running down her. She looks up and her one good eye kind of widens up and she recognizes you two.
Do I notice this?
No, it's kind of hard. She,
okay.
She's looking at all of you.
Yeah.
But you two especially feel like she's kind of eyeing, you know, both of you. And then that's where we're going to have to end the episode.
No. Yeah.
You got to. God. I wanted to ask if she recognized us. Specifically Grits.
No, you can't metagame like that.
But that's I noticed it. That they recognized her. Or something.
That's it. We'll have to wrap it up right there. And we'll find out next time. On Bards and Nobles.
Bards and Nobles.
All right. Announcements. Do we have any...
We do want to go ahead and say thanks again to everybody who came out and saw us at Magic City Con. We are looking at doing more cons and doing more fan tables wherever they are.
Yeah, really fun.
It was a lot of fun. Loved meeting everybody. And we always love going to cons anyway, so any excuse we can have to do that is awesome.
Yeah.
If you want to see us at a con, like if you're a fan, you're like, hey, this con's going on in my area, I'd love to see Bards and Nobles there. Make sure to email them and tell them that, and also reach out to social media. And let us know as well. We'd love to be there, and any kind of, if we can get any kind of invite or anything like that, we'd love it.
Yeah, I mean, obviously
we want to go where you are,
depending on logistics on going there, but you know,
I will fly to Canada where the for people you are.
So I also like to thank two new followers on Podbean, Stephen Williams 83 and Adder Hold Please.
Woohoo! Thank you guys.
Also, if you still enjoy listening to this podcast and would like to help us out financially, check out the description below the episode for our Patreon link. We would actually greatly appreciate that. That'll help us with our hosting costs and Vice's cost. So
thanks, Ben.
Thanks. Yeah, thanks, Ben.
Thanks, Ben.
And
all right, that's it.
Social media. Follow us. Sorry. Like us, share us on social media.
Yeah, it's Facebook, Instagram, Twitter.
Reviews on iTunes. That's what I was trying to think of. That would really help people find the podcast.
Yeah, if anybody uses iTunes, please leave us a review. That's going to help tremendously. Help more people discover us and, you know.
Exactly. Thanks for listening, guys.
If you are on social media, be on the lookout. We're going to be doing more giveaways coming up.
Yeah.
And one more thing.
No, let's wrap it up. Let's go.
Night, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Well, we stand here in a row, looking like a bunch of heroes. I know that deep inside, nothing more but a bunch of zeros. Yeah!